Good morning, mga mahal, my fellow gods, beloved. It is raining and cool. Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful morning. Oh, we praise you, Lord, and we glorify you, O God. You are worthy of glory and honor and praise, Father. Yes, so good, Lord. You are so awesome. You are so wonderful. Hallelujah. And you are with us right now. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Oh, moon baby, so cute. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. It's nice and cool. Beautiful morning. Hallelujah, Jesus. We praise you, Lord. We acknowledge your presence, oh Father God. As we continue, as we are going to continue to read, yes, Lord, your love message for us today. Thank you. Hallelujah. Jesus shall take the highest honor, yes, Lord. Oh, Jesus shall take the highest praise. Yes, God. Come, mga mahal, let's continue to read God's Word. We have not been reading for quite some time. The, you know, the Bible, God's love message, God's love letter for us. Let's continue on reading. And my little friends had their breakfast, the birds, and now my little fish also had their food, and so my tortoise, my little froggy also is somewhere here, but they have to go later on. They have to go to the bigger house as well, right? To the froggy? Yes. Okay. The tortoise will stay here for a while, but little froggy has to go also. My little fish stay for a while as well. And thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day. Come, mga mahal, let's continue on reading God's word for us today in 2 Corinthians chapter 12. Father God, as we continue to read your word again today, Lord, help us to understand, Father. Give us, O God, Lord, the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you, precious Lord Jesus, as we continue to read your love letter for us today. Hallelujah. We are so blessed, Father, to have you, Lord, in our lives, and that without you, Lord, we are nothing, Father God, but with you, O God, we have everything. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Oh, yes. I am so, so blessed. Thank you, Lord. Come, let's go and continue on reading God's word. Paul's vision and his thorn in the flesh. This boasting will do no good, but I must go on. I will reluctantly tell about visions and revelations from the Lord. I was caught up to the third heaven 14 years ago. Wow. I was caught up to the third heaven 14 years ago. And the Lord, he saw a vision, and also God revealed to him. Whether I was in my body or out of my body, I don't know. Only God knows. Yes, only God knows whether I was in my body or outside my body. But I do know that I was caught up to paradise and heard things so astounding that they cannot be expressed in words, things no human is allowed to tell. Wow. That experience is worth boasting about. But I'm not going to do it. I will boast only about my weaknesses. If I wanted to boast, I would be no fool in doing so because I would be telling the truth. But I won't do it because I don't want anyone to give me credit beyond what they can see in my life or hear in my message. Even though I have received such wonderful revelations from God. So, to keep me from becoming proud, I was given a thorn in my flesh, a messenger from Satan to torment me and keep me from becoming proud. 3 different times I begged the Lord to take it away. Each time he said, "My grace is all you need. My power works best in weaknesses." My grace is sufficient for you. In other translation, the Lord is saying to him, "My power works best in weakness." So, now I am glad to boast about my weaknesses so that the power of Christ can work through me. That's why I take pleasure in my weaknesses and in the insults, hardships, persecution, and troubles that I suffer from for Christ. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Wow. So Paul concerns for the Corinthians. You have made me act like a fool, boasting like this. You ought to be writing recommendations for me, for I am not at all inferior to these superior apostles. Even though I am nothing at all, when I was with you, I certainly give you proof that I am an apostle, for I patiently did many signs and wonders and miracles among you. The only thing I failed to do, which I do in the other churches, was to become a financial burden to you. Please forgive me for this wrong. Now I am coming to you for the third time, and I will not be a burden to you. I don't want what you have. I want you. After all, children don't provide for the parents. Rather, parents provide for the children. I will gladly spend myself and all I have for you, even though it seems that the more I love you, the less you love me. Some of you admitted I was not a burden to you, but others still think I was sneaky and took advantage of you by trickery. But how? Did any of the men I sent to you take advantage of you? When I urged Titus to visit you and sent our other brother with him, did Titus take advantage of you? No, for we have the same spirit and walk in each other's steps, doing things the same way. Perhaps you think you're saying these things just to defend ourselves. No, we tell you this as Christ's servants and with God as our witnesses. As our witness, God is our witness. Everything we do, dear friends, is to strengthen you. For I am afraid that when I come, I won't like what I find, and you won't like my response. I'm afraid that I will find quarreling, jealousy, anger, selfishness, slander, gossip, arrogance, and disorderly behavior. Yes, I'm afraid that when I come, God will humble me in your presence. And I will be grieved because many of you have not given up your old sins. You have not repented to your impurity, sexual immorality, and eagerness to lust for pleasure. You have not yet repented, Father God. Thank you, Lord, for what we read today about Paul's visions of his throne in the flesh. And that, Lord, wow, it is so amazing that indeed Apostle Paul have sinned, said, Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Father. And that he was caught up to the third heaven. And that, God, thank you. Paul must have sinned so many things, but God, thank you, because our faith is in you, Lord, and we are so blessed to have you help us, Father, that we will be walking in love and in harmony with you, Father, and help us, Lord Jesus. Oh God, thank you, until we see you face to face, until we caught up on the third heaven as well, just like Apostle Paul. Oh God, thank you. It is so exciting always to come to know the Lord, and Father God, help us. And tomorrow we will continue on reading Paul's final advice. Thank you, mga mahal, for reading God's love message to us today. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And always remember that Jesus loves you. And you have not received the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. You may read this. You may read this prayer with me from our heart. Lord Jesus, I need you. Thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. I open the door of my life and receive you as my Savior and Lord. I repent of my sins. Thank you for the forgiveness of my sins and giving me eternal life. Make me the kind of person you want me to be. Amen. My fellow God's beloved, if you have prayed a prayer from your heart, then Christ came into your life. Your sins were forgiven. You became a child of God. You received eternal life. You began the great adventure for which God created you. And keep on reading God's word, His love message to us. And have a nice day. God bless and take care. And always remember that Jesus loves you. Goodbye. God bless and take care.